Hello, my name is Sean Kyle, and I'm the state soybean and small grains extension specialist at the University of Wisconsin-Madison. Today what I want to discuss is some early season emergence problems we've been seeing in 2009 with soybean. First thing we really need to do is sit down and assess our stands and look at what's actually occurring with a soybean plant. If we go down and look at the growth stages as these beans begin to emerge, what we generally see here is some variability in emergence. And what we've seen and had questions with us 2009 is, does variability in emergence indicate some type of yield loss that could potentially occur as we see in corn? And the data that we've seen is even if we have as many as a 7 to 14 days difference in soybeans emergence timing across a field, we generally do not see any yield loss associated with that. Now, in terms of the emergence itself, one of the things that we've seen this last year with soybean is, again, a slow, delayed emergence. It's driven by two factors. First of all, as growers begin to plant beans earlier and earlier, we're putting them into an environment where soybeans are slower and slower to emerge. In general, it takes somewhere between 130 and 140 heat units to get soybeans out of the ground and it hit that 50% emergence timing. Now, what does often makes it difficult is if we plant corn and beans in the same day and at the same depth, corn will actually emerge earlier because it takes between 120, 125 heat units to get corn out of the ground, where it takes a little bit more to get beans out of the ground. Now, as we're assessing our stands with soybean, how do we call it emergence? Again, this would be considered a VE soybean growth stage. We see the cotyledons are just out of above the soil surface and they have emerged. Now, in terms of some of the yield loss questions that we've seen this upcoming year is related to earlier planting, working some wet soils, and actually some compaction issues and getting some cotyledon loss in soybeans. So we'll use this bean right here as a very good example. Let's say we are coming in, we pull the soybean out of the ground, okay, and during the emergence time, we actually have loss of one cotyledon, okay? If we lose one cotyledon, there's generally no yield loss associated with this. One cotyledon will be able to sustain the soybean plant up to that V1 growth stage or VC growth stage when the plant no longer relies on those cotyledons for any type of nutrient availability or utilization. Now, the question then comes in if we lose both cotyledons and all we have is basically our unifoliate soybean leaves, the first true leaves coming off that bean. If we're at the unifoliate stage and we've lost both cotyledons, what we generally see is somewhere between a 2% and 7% yield loss associated with that. Again, so that range is based on different fields, different research coming out in different parts of the country. But again, that's the yield loss that we generally see associated with that type of injury. Now, another issue that we've been able to see, and I want to bring this to our attention, is some frost injury and basically the loss of stems due to frost. Now, for looking and assessing a stand, what we have to remember with, for example, in this situation, we'll look at the soybean plant, is that if we have frost come in and hit a soybean field, remember the threshold is 28 degrees Fahrenheit for 2 hours. So let's say generally what we'll tend to see lost first are the unifoliates. So let's say for an example, we lost our unifoliates. Okay, they were frosted out. What we generally see here is basically no yield loss. And the reason for that is soybeans can be able to begin axillary meristem growth at our two cotyledons. If we look right here, we see our axillary meristems that are in a sense inhibited from growth when we have the apical meristem intact. However, if that's removed or lost due to deer feeding, due to frost injury, what we generally see is we can see some branching out of soybeans. And a good example of that, we've all seen this in deer feed foraging along the side of a field, you'll see two trifoliates basically emerging from each one of these axillary meristems on the cotyledons. From that point forward, one of them will begin apical dominance again, and the plant will basically regrow and continue to grow, and we generally see no yield loss. So again, as we go through and we're making these assessments, remember, as long as we have the stem intact and growth, or any injury above the cotyledons, early season injury, we generally do not see any yield loss.